This is the elder brother Stephen in the hotel in Aberdeen on Archie's funeral day, the 18th of March.
2016.
Yeah. This is Robert in the silhouette. Let's get a better. There's Robert. Then we have the Wiltshire man.
Supporting us over long periods of time, and our thoughts are very much with you all at his service today. Signed, George K. Yule, Vice Chairman, Aberdeen Football Club. A man who always thought of others actually was very community-minded. At one time he stood as an independent councillor and was also a member of Woodside Community Council. It goes without saying for us in this place that he was a valued elder of the Kirk Session of this congregation. He served High Hilton for many years in differing capacities. Perhaps his most significant role was as a member of the Property Committee. He had an extensive knowledge of this building. Whenever property matters were being discussed, Archie could give chapter and verse on all works done through the years. His contribution was invaluable. As a district elder, Archie was diligent and caring, visiting his folk whenever it was required. I shall miss him most on Sunday mornings. Archie was the first here. He opened the place. He filled my glasses of water. And prior to that, during the week, he had put the hymns and the hymn boards and the readings on this side. And Sunday mornings, after he had gone about his chores, he would seat himself down here in this front row in the transept. And the first thing that we did was discuss the football scores. This was usually the successes of the Dons and the ill fortunes of St. Mirren. However, the Dons weren't always doing so well, and Archie always had an answer to the misfortunes. The manager's got to go. Many people have an Archie story to tell, and I am sure that you will do just that today as we remember this great character. Please allow me to relate just two of my favourites. One was from my very early days here, and in fact my first week in the manse when a funeral had to be performed. Archie appeared at my door, as he was wont to do at many people's doors, and he said to me, "Did I know where Hazelhead Crematorium was?" And I said to him, whilst not having been there, I didn't know where it was. But he insisted immediately that I got my coat, got in his car, and he would take me there just to make sure I would get there for the funeral. So we went to Hazelhead, not just to the road end, but right in, right round it and back again. And I made myself a resolution at that point that this would be the one time I would be in Archie's car. I did try and remind him that there were speed limit signs, which he seemed to ignore with great aplomb. My other abiding recollection of him, apart from our weekly chats, was that this hymn board here, over in that side, the cut session are laughing, they know the story, actually appeared at my door one afternoon with this hymn board in several pieces, as when he had arrived to put the hymns up as in pieces on the floor. Such was Archie's diligence and care over his duties that this was a major tragedy for Archie, and he just didn't know what to do, so he brought it up to the manse. I tried to assure him that this was not the end of the world, and that we would either repair it or we would get a new one. He was a bit happy at that, so laid it down in the middle of my sitting room floor and went to go away. I said, "What on earth are you doing? I don't want that in the middle of my floor." So I dispatched him back down here with it to the office. On the following Sunday, our then organist Tim came to church, and as usual, Archie was the first in. And Archie approached Tim and said, "There's been a tragedy. You must come and see." Tim's heart missed several beats. He thought there was going to be a body lying in the corridor. He was taken through and shown the hymn board in several pieces. And it was repaired, and there it stands, or sits, or whatever it does, hangs. And Archie, up until not that long ago, was still putting the hymn numbers up on a Sunday morning. All our sympathies today are with you folks. You are Archie's family, and our loss is your loss. As you mourn, we also mourn today. So our sympathies are with Robert, Stephen and Sandy. I recall Archie telling me how much he enjoyed his holidays with you. And near our home, we share Archie's loss with George, Linda, Jim and Elizabeth, and further afield with Eleanor and Elsie. Archie Robertson will be remembered for his unique character and his cuthy personality. We also give thanks today for a trusted and reliable friend who made himself and his car available to help at any time. Archie was a good man with a good heart. And we can also rejoice today that Archie now resides in the nearer presence of his Lord and his Master. Thanks be to God for the life of Archie Robertson. Let us pray.
Thank you.
in peace. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you all this day and forevermore. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Archie was a good man with a good heart. And we can also rejoice today that Archie now resides in the near presence of his Lord and his Master. Thanks be to God for the life of Archie Robertson.